Well, g'day, Tubes. How's she hanging? Frickin' big snow day, apparently, today. There's even snow, see, along the edge of the door. So that's great. Big, big snow day. I'm gonna try to record plowing, and holy crap. Well, it's not too bad, but it's enough. I'm gonna try to record some plowing as long as the camera will last. We even got snow drifts. Holy snow. This is Monday and I was actually out twice yesterday. Doing snow. Well, we'll just put her under the trailer. Well, that's blown in snow. That's probably 8-10 inches there, but it drifts in and comes off the roof, so it's not all exactly what we got there. But you can see the car is gone. Poor car. Kids having no bus day. Got lucky yesterday plowing snow up close to the car here. What happened was I was coming across here and it caught something on the edge here and it was coming and it just kind of went like this. The plow went right in here, right in behind the car. So I got lucky with that. Probably caught a piece of ice or something. Really drifted up here. That'll all get covered again when she comes out to uncover the car, but anyways, let's push this down just a little more. And I can come up with the plow and then push her. Okay. I'll leave that there. Get the gate open. Oh, that's a good workout. Oh crap. I'll grab my other shovel and I'm at the garage. I'd have to do. Ooh, it's cold out here too. Might have to put my other equipment on. I'll have to and I'm gonna take with me, I think, and warm it up. just a little sticky there. Sorry, I have to bring my other shovel so I can do it around the gate before it kind of turns to cement. Well, it's not actually as much as I thought here. It must have just been more blowing around. It was hardly anything. Oh well, we'll still plow. Still have to plow. So I'll probably pause for a moment while I throw my pants on and stuff, my snow pants, bigger gloves, my other hat. Ooh, this is icy here. Wow, I threw piles of salt down too the other day. Didn't hardly do anything. So much ice. There's a woodpecker working in there. Oh, there he just flew out. One of those big pleated ones, those great big huge ones. They leave those great big holes in the trees. Freaking massive, huge birds. That lick, you could hear that. That was him banging on the tree. But we scared him, so. Oh yeah, there's not that much snow, but I was out sweeping, well, plowing and sweeping yesterday. And the sweeping, it was kind of sticky snow and it didn't really flick it off too well, so I'm gonna have to go out plowing and rip her off. Oh wow. Yesterday I banged all the edges of this off and it's slowly come down again. Wow, you can see that layer of ice. I don't know if this camera's picking it up, but there's like a layer of ice there and then this much snow on top. It's pretty sweet. So we'll get the door up. This has got quite an arc here too. It's actually coming back in. Huh. Sweet. And let's fire this up. Just got all nicely dried off. Now I go get dressed here. So I gotta take my coat off first. Take my coat off first. Hit my pants here. And they split down the sides with zippers, so you can just kind of throw them on here. Step into them. Flip up your shoulder dewies. Zip them up there. Zip the sides. Zip that side. Probably should change my hat here. Hang on. My lovely wife many years ago sewed on an extra piece of material because I always felt that it was coming through your coat and nailing you right on the throat, and it freaking sucked. So that kind of hangs down there, and then the coat goes on over top. Like that. And then I usually put on another toque on top of this, but because I'm wearing the camera today, I'm gonna try it. I don't know if it's gonna work though. Might be alright. Might get a little tight though after a while. Okay. Thank you. hydraulics on. That gives me control there now. Close our door. Yep. Put our bucket down. Straighten the hole out. Align our this way. Just a little bit down. We're in range C, more throttle. With me, we'll grab shovel. Does a nice path, eh? It cleans pretty good. Leaves a little bit, but it was a little high here, so it kind of, you know, and then leaves a little skim there, but supposed to be only 20% chance today. Look, I threw a bunch of salt on here too, and still rock hard. Almost need to throw a whole 20 kilogram bag on that, I think. Maybe we could throw a bag of salt on that, but no, not that shovel. This shovel. I guess I'll go back out this way. I think I just closed my door though, so oh well. The door can open again. Actually, it's funny, this door is pretty big. You can only open and close it about 10 times, and then that thing thermally shuts down. She thermals out. Ooh, that was a hard scrape. I don't be doing that too much. That chunk needs to be redone anyways, the asphalt. About there to there, about maybe 8 feet out from the door, it's all gone sinky, so. There we go. Can you imagine doing the whole cemetery like this? Oh, that would suck. Or this. No! I'll go to Florida. Okay, let's get at her. Try to widen the roads here a little bit. times I thought I was gonna be out here. Still see bare road places. to get the big scooping bucket on later and scoop that crap away from the gate. It's starting to build up too high. Okay, let's do the gate stuff here now. Actual manual labor. Holy. Get in there and just with a blade, but that's all right. And I'll get the worst of her. That should do. Good. Lock this guy down. Ish. All right. Let's keep pushing. Ugh. In a moment. And there we go, we are done. Now I'm gonna do some salting, but I might save that for another video. So I'm trying to relieve pressure on the plow, as you guys told me, to get pressure off so the fittings will go better next time. But I don't know if that's gonna help. What I think happens is when this thing gets settled, the hydraulics relax a bit, but then it settles and it starts to push more one on the other side or vice versa, whatever, and then it creates pressure back on the fitting. That's kind of all I can see. When I relieve the pressure on the fittings here, it works fine, which I guess allows a little extra room for that little bit of pressure built up. So yeah, that's the dilemma anyway. So, but I found sometimes they freeze up too and you can't push them together. So what I do is just run it on the exhaust for 10-20 seconds, and then usually they'll clip on. So but I hate those kind of fittings anyways. They're supposed to be no drip fittings, so you don't lose oil, but you take the fitting off and drain all the oil out, so don't ask me. Oh, get under there. Okay, so we'll back out of this and I'll hook onto that. And we'll probably chop the video there and start a new one. Okay, so here we go. Okay, let's see here. Lock him down. Lift that guy off. Now, I did the same thing when I released the pressure on this, so we'll see if these go on. Sometimes this thing's been a nightmare too. That one's good. Good. Well, no, we got her. Whew. Just needed a little more. So there we go. Yeah, I gotta fill her up with some salt. My cover works good. Yeah. So the only thing that's rusting on this is that little auger thing in the, that's not maybe too good. I don't know. But anyways, that's it for snow plowing. Hopefully you enjoyed. Next day, tomorrow we'll do some more salt spreading. Then I gotta wash it out, man. I washed it out too, and it's already taking a toll on it. Maybe it should have paint on it too, I don't know. But anyways, thanks for watching. Catch you later.